Hello students, welcome to one of the most fascinating chapter, and that is human reproduction. And in this module, we will be learning about the male reproductive system. Humans are sexually reproducing and viviparous. The male reproductive system is composed of a pair of testes, male sex accessory ducts and the accessory glands, and the external genitalia. Transverse section of testes. The transverse section of testes reveals the outermost layer, which is known as the tunica albuginea. Within the testes, there are about 250 testicular lobules. Each testicular lobule contains 3 to 4 seminiferous tubules, which are regarded as the structural and the functional unit of the testes. In the seminiferous tubules, there are two types of cells. The first one is the Sertoli cells, which is also known as the sustentacular cells. These are tall and pillar-like cells. The second one is the primordial germ cells, which are the rounded cells. The Sertoli cells are also called as the nurse cells. This is because they provide nourishment for the developing sperms. Between the seminiferous tubules, the gap is filled by the tissues, and this tissue is called as the interstitial tissues. And the cells present there are called as the interstitial cells or the Leydig cells. The Leydig cells produces the male sex hormone, which is known as the testosterone. The accessory ducts are the rete testes, the vasa efferentia, the epididymis, and the vas deferens. The accessory glands are the seminal vesicles, the prostate gland, as well as the bulbourethral gland. The male sex accessory ducts includes, as we studied, the rete testis, the vasa efferentia, the epididymis, and the vas deferens. The seminiferous tubules of the testes opens into the vasa efferentia through the rete testis. The vasa efferentia leaves the testes and opens into the epididymis located along the posterior surface of each testis. The epididymis leads to the vas deferens that ascends to the abdomen and loops over the urinary bladder. It receives a duct from the seminal vesicle and opens into the urethra as the ejaculatory duct, which stores and transports the sperms into the urethra. The urethra originates from the urinary bladder and extends through the penis to its external opening called the urethral meatus. The male external genitalia is also called as the penis. The penis is made up of special tissue that helps in the erection of the penis to facilitate the insemination. The enlarged end of the penis is called as the glans penis, which is covered by a loose fold of skin, which is called as the foreskin. The male accessory glands include the paired seminal vesicles, a single prostate gland, and the paired bulbourethral gland, which is also known as the Cowper's gland. Secretions of all these three glands constitute the fluid called as the seminal plasma or the semen, which is rich in fructose, calcium, and several enzymes. The secretions of the bulbourethral gland also helps in the lubrication of the penis. Thank you.